Hi everyone, welcome back again. In this video, we will learn how to set up web server for F5 Labs. Here I am using a simple Windows 7 machine with 1 GB RAM, 1 CPU, 20 GB hard disk. That's it. Windows 7 iOS you can get anywhere from internet. And as you can see here, network adapter of my server 1, I named it as a server 1, but basically this is the Windows 7 machine and its network adapter, it's custom and connected to VMnet 0 host only, and our F5 Big IP's network adapter 3, that is our lab topologies Ethernet 1.2, which is inside, that is also connected to same VMnet adapter, that is VMnet 0 host only type. Okay, so this both the network adapters are connected to same VMnet adapter. Okay, so both the machines can communicate with each other. Likewise, other three servers I'm going to configure with the same configuration. So let's power on this machine. Here I have given 1 GB of RAM. But for running a web server, 512 MB is also enough. I tried it. It works fine. But for a host machine, from the machine where from you're going to access a web server pool, that machine should be with a 1 GB RAM at least. Okay, so on this Windows 7 machine, I've installed a web server. You can see, I'll explain the process how to enable or how to install a web server on your Windows 7 machine. To install a web server on your Windows machine, go to Control Panel, then go to Programs, then turn on Windows feature on off. Then click on this option, Internet Information Services, IIS server. We call it as a IIS server. Enable FTP. Keep it enabled. We will need it in next video, so enable it. This is the web management tool. Select this also, IIS management console. This will create this option, IIS management console. Then under the worldwide web services, select this options. So this all options should check marked, make sure it. under the this all options comes under Internet Information Services. Select FTP server, FTP extensibility, FTP services, web management tool, IIS management console, then worldwide web services. No, nothing is selected here. Then common HTTP features, then all this features also. Then click on OK. After that, go to control panel. All options, administrative tools. Then this is the option. After enabling IIS server, these options you get under control panel, all control panel items, administrative tool. Click on it and you can create a shortcut to your desktop also if you are going to use it frequently. From this Internet Information Services IIS Manager option, you can manage your website hosted on your Windows 7 machine. For right now, we will keep it minimized. Before that, I'll show you a simple trick to create a web page. Open Notepad, type anything what you want. You can type whatever you want, then select save as. I will save this file at desktop with name test, then save as a type all. And save the file name with dot extension, that is HTML. See, if you double click on it, it will open with your web browser. See, hi everyone. Close it now. Then go to your computer, then C drive. After enabling IIS server, it will create this option, inetpub. Under the inetpub, go to www.rroot, then create here one folder. Continue. Test. We will save this file in this folder. Continue. Then now go to IIS server option. Add a website. Website name, given name, website name, test, path. You have to give a path where it is stored. So I have stored this file in C drive, then inetpub, then www.root and test folder. Okay. It will ask you here which IP address you want to assign to this website. If you are having a multiple network or network card, all those IPs or network card you will reflect here. Select type HTTP, HTTPS, but if you select HTTPS, it will ask you for SSL certificate. For lab purpose, you can put here HTTP only, put 80 port or any other port, non-standard as well if you want. Start website immediately. Okay, binding is assigned with another site. Yes, I'll stop all this site for now so we can test our newly created site. Start. Okay, go to default. After that you'll have to click on test, then go to default documents, and actually you have to save the file here in this folder. You'll have to save the file with these names, but we have saved the file with test name. Okay, so we'll have to add another file here with same name, that is test.html. Okay, so we can test the site. Browse 10.1.1.0 on HTML .at port. So it's working fine. This is not done here. Few things you need to enable still on your system. This website you can access on your local machine only for right now. If you want to access this website from your local network as well as from publicly, then you'll have to enable some firewall rules. Your Windows machine, you'll have to give some rules on your Windows firewall. So for that, just go to control panel, then system security, firewall, allow, change setting, and if you see here, you'll have to enable this option. You'll have to give this check mark here, then home network, private, give a check mark, and public as well, give a check mark, then click on allow, and then click on OK. We have enabled FTP as well, so you'll have to check mark here for FTP as well. Select FTP, then give a check mark for private as well as for public. Still, if it is not working, then we will have to create an inbound rule on your firewall like this. Web server. Profiles all, yes. Enable, yes. Action allow. Override no. Program any. Local address any. Remote address any. Which protocol? TCP. For protocol 80. If you want, you can add another protocol as well. Here I added 2424. 2425. Remote port any. Allow user any. Allow computer any. I'll show you how to create a new rule here. Click on new rule, then program. We will select a port number, then go to next. Which port you want, whether it is TCP or UDP, we will select UDP here. All ports. So if you want to allow only specific port, mention here those port with a semicolon. For example, 80, 100, 5000, whatever you want, or else you can simply allow all the poles. Okay, then click on next action. What action you want to take on this rule, with this rule, what action you want to take, allow the connection if it is secure, block the connection if you want to deny the traffic, then click on OK. From which domain user can access this site? From same domain, from private or publicly, then click on next. Name the rule, give a description, it's optional, and finish. That's it. See here, rule is created on the top. Allow. Everything is allowed, but I will delete this rule because already I have created the rule for my web server. That's it. So these are the things only you need to change on your Windows 7 machine. Then you can access the web page or web server hosted on your Windows 7 machine from anywhere. That's it. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. In next video, we will start with the load balancing. What are the types of load balancing? How to enable load balancing on FI load balancer? So stay tuned. Subscribe the channel. Have a good day. Bye bye. See you in next video.